Wow, it is so tall. What do you get when you engineer over 10 million pounds of steel, 350 feet high? A very unique, capable, and monstrous mobile launcher. We're here at the Kennedy Space Center, ready to make a move on the mobile launcher. And to tell us a little bit more about the mobile launcher today is our senior project manager, Cliff Landon. Cliff, how's it going today?
Doing well, Heath.
Fantastic. Now, Cliff, can you tell us a little bit more about the mobile launcher and what it does?
Sure. The mobile launcher is designed to allow platform for stacking, assembling, testing, and checking out the SLS and Orion. It's also used to transfer the vehicle out to the pad and also the platform that the rocket will actually launch from.
Now, was this mobile launcher used in previous launches?
No, it wasn't. It was actually built originally for the Ares 1 program. NASA repurposed it, got some cost efficiencies to use it for SLS and Orion. Now, with SLS being a much bigger, more powerful rocket, we've had to do increased structural modifications to the tower and base, as well as enlarge the flame hole. Now, part of those renovations have included adding over 40 subsystems that include mechanical, electrical, and fluid systems, as well as miles and miles of tube and piping.
Okay. Now, the mobile launcher has those umbilicals that hang to the side of them. What are those used for?
Well, there's 20 launch accessories and umbilicals that provide coolant, power, data, fuel, those types of commodities to the rocket.
And then, so when you talk about T minus zero, is that the actual point where the rocket lifts off?
That's right. T zero is when the signal's given, the rocket ignites and it's going, and the umbilical arms will retract back toward the tower and get out of the way of the rocket as it's coming by.
And so how exactly does the mobile launcher go from the vehicle assembly building over to the pad?
What happens is a crawler transporter comes in underneath the base of the mobile launcher, picks it up off its pedestals, and then will roll out to either the VAB to begin rocket stacking, or it'll take the rocket out from the VAB to the pad to get ready for launch.
So the crawler is capable of lifting the mobile launcher with the rocket stacked on it?
That's correct.
Very well, very well. So Cliff, thank you so much for the tour, and I look forward to all of NASA's future endeavors. Thank you so much.